hockey fans, welcome to another edition of Wolves Hockey Show, the number one rated hockey theme show on Lakes Region Public Access. We've had a busy couple weeks here as we stretch into the end of the season with our Wolves hockey program. The junior teams have been in action. You can actually see our EHLP team is currently practicing right behind me. And to start things off, that EHLP team had a three-game series in which they traveled out to Adirondack, New York, Glens Falls, New York, to be specific. And they battled one of the top teams in the league. They didn't get the results they were looking for, but they showed a lot of signs of progress as they head on to the stretch run of the season. We've got a couple clips we're going to show you of the EHLP team at Cool Insuring Arena. They got one for you right now.
Tried to recollect that. It's number 21, Dominique Dojakives. He'll be collecting that, a chance for him to make the World Junior Championship roster in a couple of years. He is the real deal, one of the billets on this team for Lafayette. Back the other way, and a save once more. Scramble in front, and they score. It looks like Dominique Dojakives took the initial shot, and it was a scramble in front, and it will be number 14, Harrison Kramer, getting his first goal of the game, and what a shot. Out there right now for the Wolves. It's Fitzgerald with a chance for Markoski. He just kind of floats it on. Markoski tries to find Kramer and he scores. Kramer and Markoski were battling for possession. Kramer just fires it home past the five hole and the Wolves are on the board. It's Harrison Kramer.
Thunder down low with it once again. Salone to Markoski, up to Blanchard. He loses it just across the blue line. Across with it now, Evan Duvall. Tries to get a backhand wrap around. Kian Hodgins is down. And we'll see what happens here. Referee on the ice calls it a good goal.
Kian wants a goalie interference. You can see his frustration, but it looks like, honestly, he just got kind of pushed in a little bit there.
We'll see how. So some highlights for the EHLP team last weekend was the play of some of our defensemen, and specifically Derek Boulot, who's had a standout season on the back end for our team, as well as both Sember brothers. They've recommitted to the program to come back next year, and they've been some of the standout players all season long for both the EHLP team and our U16s. To start the show, you heard our goal song. That's become popular here at the Metal Fay Arena. Every time the Wolves score, they play that Hall & Oates classic, and it was started by our EHL team about a year and a half ago when they had a 10-goal outburst against the East Coast Wizards. Now, speaking of that EHL team, they had some good results against the New Hampshire Avalanche, recording a 7-5 victory here on home ice, and that's a big team, knocking off the top team in the league, according to the EHL's power rankings. We got a couple clips we're going to show you. The EHL team coming up for you right now.
To the draw for the Wolves and can't cleanly win it, but Kowalski's there to stop the puck from any further exit zone. But Andropoulos is there. Gets stopped up by Laracy. That's Heath Mensch. Shot scores! Heath Mensch! The hat trick for Heath Mensch against the New Hampshire Avalanche. Is able to give them a little bit more of a cushion. And he'll send it up to the defenseman with a shot that'll go into the corner that can be picked up by the other defenseman. Herta now behind the Wolves net will reverse it to Kowalski. Kowalski will send it up to Valenta. Valenta might have a break here. Valenta shot, scores! Dennis Valenta with a good stretch from Kowalski. And is able to slip it 5-0 on Parambola. Real good defense.
Recently signed netminder Cam Reardon has been playing really solid in nets. He's teamed up with Trevor Jewell, who's a SUNY Brockport commitment, to give us stability on the back end. Cam Reardon hails from Berlin, New Hampshire. He grew up playing in Berlin, but then also migrated south to the Wolves and has played in our 16s. And now is playing on our EHL team. Wish Cam continued success, as we're going to need him here in the stretch run. One of the goaltenders in this program, Jack Castle, is a first-year player with us. He's battled through some different injuries, but he's emerged as a really bright young star on our EHLP team. He originally hails from Pennsylvania, and he's back in action and ready to go as the season progresses here into the stretch run for the playoffs. We got an interview coming up for you with Jack Castle. All right, Wolves fans, we're here with Jack Castle, one of the goaltenders on our EHL Premier Team. He's battled injuries throughout the season, but he's back and ready for the playoffs. Welcome to Wolves Hockey Show, Jack.
Thanks, Coach.
Now, your hip is feeling better. Tell me a little bit about the progress with your hip this season. What's been going on?
Well, I was out for about 4 or 5 months throughout the whole season. Battled, just recovery. Went to physical therapy, orthopedics, and we battled back and back to work.
Good. Now, the good news is that you won't need surgery. That's what we're hearing. So
yeah.
You'll be able to kind of, you know, treat it without getting that surgery. And how is it feeling now as you prepare for these last couple games for the playoffs?
It's been good. Just stretching out, loosening up, and it works. Flexible, back to normal.
Good. Now, the team is a little bit on a skid. We've had 5 games here. We haven't got a ton of wins. You've gotten some points against some good teams, but what does the team need to do in these next couple weeks to prepare for playoffs?
I think we just need to battle through adversity. We're getting tired, and we just need to fight through that. And if we do that, we could be any team.
Yeah, you want to be accelerating towards the playoffs, not dipping, right?
Yeah.
And I agree with you. This team's got the capability to do everything they want to do, but you got to put in the work, right?
Yeah.
So you got to find a way. Well, there you have it, hockey fans, from Jack Castle finding a way towards the playoffs. Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, Coach.
So special thanks to Jack Castle for jumping on the show with us. He appeared earlier on in the year during one of our Christmas segments, but now he had his own time as an interview. And what really sticks out is how much, you know, how his imposing size really helps him in net. He's a technically strong goaltender. He's got a good demeanor in nets, but also he's got a big frame that's still going to fill out some more. And he's posed for a bright career down the road. So keep up the hard work, Jack Castle. I know you'll be able to put this injury bug in the rearview mirror and have success in your hockey career. Now, speaking about hockey careers, our alumni players have really, really shined bright for the Wolves program all season long. We've got a clip we're going to show you of some of their recent successes and familiar names for you guys. Stuff like Declan House, Patrick Marcin Kevex, and many others have been shining at the next level and having terrific seasons. That clip on EHL alumni coming up for you right now. More recent alumni news for the Wolves. It's been a great 22-23 season for all our former players. Declan House had a great weekend last weekend with 3 points in 2 games, including the assist on the game-tying goal for Franklin Pierce. Patrick Marcin Kevex continues to shine for Long Island University. So far in the season, he has 23 points in his freshman season, in addition to being the Division I Player of the Month in December. Adam Barnes had a great weekend over in the UK with his professional team. And lastly, Roger Powers, congratulations on senior night. Now, upcoming events. We got a bunch of games coming up for you this week. We have mostly road games, though, so our local fans will not be able to attend in person, but they can certainly watch on Hockey TV. The EHLP team travels down to the Seahawks Hockey Club, where they got a big contest coming up on Friday. And then on Saturday, the Wolves will travel to Walpole, Mass. They'll play the Express Hockey Club at both the EHL and EHLP levels. And we're looking for some big results out of those Northern rival games. So good luck to all our teams in action. Our 16s are practicing on Thursdays now as their high school seasons start to conclude. And we're looking forward to their Nationals berth as they punch their ticket to Buffalo, New York, to go play in the USA Hockey Nationals at the end of March and then the first weekend in April. Good luck to our 16s. Really proud of the job that John McKenzie and head coach John Guerin have done for the 16s. And we're looking forward to some exciting results as the season concludes. When it comes to trying out for our program for next year, you can go to our website. We got a clip we're going to show you of what that looks like in terms of signing up for next year's tryouts and then coming out and competing in mid-March to play for the Wolves for the 23-24 season. And also, to conclude the show, we're going to show you some of the top plays in the EHL this week. The Wolves were featured prominently with many of our goal scorers, and also Cam Reardon, we mentioned earlier, had a big save against Seacoast Spartans. So, EHL Clips of the Week will conclude the show for us, and thanks for everybody for tuning in to the Wolves Hockey Show, which remains the number one rated hockey team show on Lake Region Public Access. Thanks, fans. Go to the Wolves website, www.ne-wolveshockey.com, to register for tryouts today. U16, U18, and the Wolves Junior program. Sign up, it's only $20.
Tracy lays out a hit on the forecheck. Dellelia, the other way, looking for the hat trick. Backhand, saved by Crosby. What a save by Lincoln Crosby. Face-off for Team Maryland. He loses it to Hoat. One-timer from the point. Loose puck in front. Another big save there by Crosby.
Trying to send in Rebroker. It's worked by Hotchkiss. Larivere. Pucking it ahead. Puck comes available, and here's Rebroker. Robbie Rebroker to the backhand, and he scores! This game is tied as Robbie Rebroker able to move in on the backhand.
Here's Vasin. Vasin skates in. Backhander, he scores! It's a hat trick for Vasily Vasin in just his second game at Jersey Shore Arena.
Faceoff coming up to the right of Reardon. And it's won by the Wolves. They play it out. Oh, loose in front. John, what a save! Cameron Reardon robbed Prey. He was all alone in front of the net. Tried to lift it over Reardon's pad, but Reardon gets his pad up in the air and robs him. What a save by Reardon early in this one.
Face off. Won by Bean. Bean with it now. Ooh, walks around. Adam shot and he scores. That was a great move there from Atticus Bean, making it 4-1.
Up top, over. Down below the net to BJR. Oh, what a pass, what a play, what a goal. Will Halecki with a nice spin around the back pass going behind the net, fooling Jack Boscher, and it was buried by Sean Sr. What a great play by BJR there.
Bench, over to Budina. What a shot, what a goal! Matthias Budina walked into the slot, shot blocker side, snipe Skelton.
Larry's check put in front, deflected.
Budina picks the puck, he scores! Matthias Budina, his second of the game.
Up top for Herta.
One-timer shot, just misses the net. Loose, they score! Budina, hat-trick! Woo! What a goal! Matthias Budina!
Colin Craig, near side, shift by Collard. He's still got the puck to the far end. What a goal! Colin Craig, turnstile Jack Collard, went to the forehand, glove side high on Kulhonik, and he evens the score here with 2:33 to go.
Jonah Bird out with it here in overtime. Crossing over the Seahawks line, Bird trying to rag it around Muniz. Here's Bird from his knees, and he scores! Jonah Bird on a solo job in overtime wins the game for the Express. 2-1 the final here in sudden death overtime.
Mellis powers through. Mellis through his legs, he scores! Akajan Mellis with one of the better goals you'll see all season long.
For more information on the Wolves program, check out our website, www.ne-wolveshockey.com.